Welcome to the Mobile Money Nation. My name is AJ. Thanks for taking this time out of your day to watch this video. If you're not a current member of the Mobile Money Nation, all you have to do is hit the subscribe button down below. Hit the like button because you're really gonna like this video. And also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video. Amid the coronavirus or COVID-19 crisis, there are many companies that are making big changes so that they can survive throughout this time period. Many of these things include reducing spending in any way that they can so that they can save money in order to pay their bills and pay the employees that they still have on staff. And so this could include either reducing hours, potentially laying off workers, potentially furloughing workers, so they're not technically laid off, but they're not getting paid, or by reducing some of the benefits that they provide for some of their employees. And one of those benefits is the 401k match. Outside of your actual paycheck, your 401k match is probably one of the best benefits that your employer can provide to you. And with many companies just trying to stay afloat, there have already been multiple announcements of companies deciding that they're gonna either cancel or put a pause on their 401k match. As an example, Amtrak, Sabre Corp, and Norwegian Cruise Lines are three companies that just within the past week or two have decided to cancel their match. And more companies are expected to do the same. During the financial crisis back in 2008 and 2009, many companies canceled their 401k match or other benefits that they were providing to their employees. That way that they could save money and potentially reduce the chances that they may have to lay off employees. So if you happen to work for a company that hasn't laid you off, but they have paused their 401k match program, should you continue to contribute to your 401k, or should you perhaps do something else with those additional funds? And so if you don't necessarily need that additional money for your day-to-day expenses and you can afford to put it towards your retirement accounts, what I typically do is I go by the order of operations that I have for retirement accounts in general. So I'll walk through how I decide and the specific order that I choose to put my money in retirement accounts. And so typically for retirement accounts, the first contribution that I make is my actual 401k match. And with a 401k match, there are many companies that they may start off with either a 25% match, a 50% match, 75%, or you may start off when you first join the company, you may get a 100% match to your 401k. So the first thing you should do for your retirement accounts is to take advantage of the 401k match that you're receiving from your employer, and nothing more, nothing less. Just whatever that match is, the minimum you should be putting in is the maximum you need to maximize the match you receive from your employer. So why is that? Over the past 90 years, the stock market has given you an average return of about 8 to 10%, depending on which index you use to track the stock market. When you receive a 401k match, if you're receiving a 25%, 50%, 75%, or 100% match, that is your return on investment. You are immediately receiving a 25% gain or a 50%, 75%, or a 100% gain just by putting money into your 401k. And in America, the average 401k match is 4.3%, and the average income in America, the average median household income, is $56,000. So in the example, I'm gonna use a 4% match and a person who makes $50,000 as their income. So if you were to make $50,000 a year and the company you work for gives you a 4% match, as long as you put at least 4% into your 401k, that means you're gonna deposit $2,000 every year, and then depending on your company's match, you will have additional money in those funds. And so many companies out there, depending on their vesting period, eventually you will have 100% match. And so we'll use 100% match in this example, meaning that every year that you put $2,000 into your 401k, your employer is also putting $2,000 in your 401k. Just by you putting in a minimum of 4% into your 401k to maximize your 4% match, you're putting in $2,000, your employer is putting in $2,000, so that means you have $4,000 put into your 401k by the end of the year. And that's not even considering the amount of money that you could make based on the average that the market gains every year. And so using the example of an 8% average, by the end of the year, you would have almost $4,200 based on an 8% gain in the stock market. And so not only are you getting an 8% gain, you're technically getting a 108% gain because the only money that you personally had to put in from your income was the $2,000, and you ended up with roughly $4,200 by the end of the year. This is why it's so important to contribute at minimum, whatever the maximum match is that your employer provides. So as a rule of thumb, the ceiling for your employer's 401k match is the floor for the amount of money that you should put in your 401k. So if your employer has canceled the 401k match and this is no longer an option for you, then you will go on to the next step in this order of operations, which is the health savings account. Now, a health savings account, also known as an HSA, is an account that you're only eligible for if you have a high deductible health plan. And so this is an insurance plan that you can get from your employer as well. And as long as you have this specific type of health plan, you are eligible to open an HSA account. And with an HSA for individuals, you can put up to a maximum of $3,500 per year into this account. And the additional option you have within an HSA is that not only the savings account that you get, but you can also open an account where you can actually invest your HSA funds. And so this essentially turns your HSA into an additional IRA or 401k type retirement account. And with the HSA, every dollar that you put in is tax deductible. So that means you have up to $3,500 as an individual or up to $7,000 as a family where you can put into this health savings account and it will actually reduce your taxable income as well. And so you have a triple tax advantage by depositing money into your HSA because you get the initial tax deduction for depositing money into your HSA. The money that's in your HSA can also grow as an investment account tax-free. And currently you can pay any health-related expenses as well as when you get into your actual retirement time, you can pay for medical expenses and you won't be taxed on those funds that you use during that time period. And so you get a tax deduction when you deposit, you get tax-free growth in the investment account, and you get tax-free withdrawals when they're used for medical expenses. Now, any expenses that aren't related to medical, then you are taxed on those withdrawals once you're in retirement, and it's essentially treated just like a traditional IRA. And so if you want more information on how health savings accounts work, I actually have a few videos talking about health savings accounts, and I'll have a link in the description as well to the playlist for the multiple videos where I talk about HSAs. And so once you've maximized on your HSA, the next account that I will go to is a Roth IRA. Now, a Roth IRA is an individual retirement account. And with this account, you can actually deposit up to $6,000 per year or up to $7,000 per year if you are above the age of 50. Now, there are two different types of IRAs. There is the Roth IRA and the traditional IRA. And the main difference is that with the Roth IRA, your contributions to the Roth IRA are provided after you've already paid taxes on your income. With a traditional IRA, you get a tax deduction for any money that you put into the traditional IRA. And the other major difference is that with the Roth IRA, because you've already paid taxes on it, it grows tax-free. And then when you make withdrawals in your retirement, you don't have to pay taxes on those withdrawals. But with a traditional IRA, because you're getting that tax deduction upfront, once you actually make withdrawals in your retirement, then you will have to pay taxes on those withdrawals. Now, the reason that I choose putting a Roth IRA over putting money into a taxable IRA or within your 401k account is for two main reasons. If you make the average median household income in the United States, which as I mentioned before is $50,000, then you are already in a pretty low tax bracket. And more than likely, when you retire, there's a chance that you could be in a higher tax bracket. So you might as well pay lower taxes now and then don't have to pay taxes in the future because we don't have an idea of what the tax brackets will be at that time. Now, if you're in a higher tax bracket, it may help you to save money on your taxes today, and you may be making less income in the future. So it's really up to you based on how you think the government will tax people in the future, as well as how much income you plan to have currently versus what you're gonna have when you're in retirement. But one other key distinction is with RMDs. Now, an RMD stands for a required minimum distribution. And so this is a distribution or a withdrawal that you have to make once you're in retirement. And with a Roth IRA, there is no required minimum distribution for the person who created the account originally. The only requirements for a distribution would be on if you were to pass this on to another beneficiary, like your spouse or your children or a family member, your church, or maybe an organization that you decide to give the money to after you pass. However, with a traditional IRA or with a 401k, whether it's traditional or Roth, there is a required minimum distribution. And there are specific calculations that you have to think about. I won't go into details on those, but I will provide a link in the description to the IRS website so you can see what those specifications are. But the main thing is that once you reach the age of 70 and a half up to the age of 72, that is when you will be required to start withdrawing from your IRA or from your 401k. But with a Roth IRA, you wouldn't have that requirement. Now, the next account that I'll recommend you to now start putting your money in after you've gone through the other accounts is your 401k. And you can deposit into your 401k either as a traditional 401k, which would be receiving a tax deduction now, or a Roth 401k if this is available with your employer, because not all employers provide this option. If you are in a lower tax bracket now, take advantage of that by putting money into a Roth 401k. So you would pay taxes now, but in the future, you wouldn't have to pay taxes when you withdraw your funds. Now with a 401k, you can contribute up to $19,500 per year as an individual. And if you're above the age of 50, you can contribute an additional $6,500 catch-up contribution, which brings you to a total of $26,000 that you can contribute each year. Now, if you've noticed a trend in the different accounts that I've mentioned, with each account, you're able to contribute a larger amount to each of these retirement accounts. So you can kind of think of this just like the Dave Ramsey debt snowball. With the debt snowball, you pay off the smallest debts that you have, and once you finish paying off those smallest debts, you then move on to larger debt. So you can think of this as the Mobile Money Nation retirement snowball. You start contributing to the smallest retirement account that you can, and once you've maximized those accounts, then you move on to the next account to make your contribution to. And so starting from the beginning, if you are able to get a 401k match, with the average household income being $50,000, that means you're gonna contribute $2,000 if you have a 4% match. And next with the HSA, you would then contribute up to $3,500 as an individual. Then next with your Roth IRA, you'll contribute up to $6,000 as an individual. And then next with your 401k, you will contribute up to $19,500 as an individual. So as an individual, if you were to maximize all of the retirement accounts available to you, that means you would have a total of $29,000 each year put towards your retirement. And now that's not counting any gains within the stock market, and it's also not accounting the 401k match that you're receiving from your company. But because this video is about when you aren't able to get that 401k match, then we're only considering the total of $29,000 that you're eligible to contribute towards your retirement. Now, for many of you, and especially if you make less than the average median household income in the United States, you may not be able to contribute $29,000 to your retirement, because that's over 50% of your income if you're making the average income in the United States. And so many of you may not even get to the point of contributing to your 401k if you're not starting off with contributing to your 401k match. So if we only consider your HSA and your IRA account, those two alone would put you at $9,500 per year. And $9,500 out of $50,000 is almost 20% of your income. And so there are some people that may not even be able to put 20% of their income towards retirement. But if you can, I would recommend doing whatever you can to reduce your expenses. That way that you can contribute at least 20% of your income towards your retirement. So in 2020, I would like you to start contributing at least 20% towards your retirement in 2020. So this is the order that I choose to invest my retirement funds. And so if you're no longer receiving a 401k match, then you may want to start with the HSA, then go to your IRA, and then start investing into your 401k. However, if you still are receiving a match, you want to take advantage of that match, and whatever the percent that your company or your employer provides to you, that is what you should contribute to before putting any additional money in your 401k. And so if you do still receive a match, you definitely want to take advantage of that before you contribute to your HSA. And you shouldn't think of your retirement accounts as only your retirement, because eventually we're all going to pass away. And if you happen to have any funds left over at that time. You can pass along those funds to a family member, whether it's your spouse, your children, a niece or nephew or a cousin, whoever that may be, or maybe your church or an organization that's really important to you. Someone can use those funds in the future. So give yourself a retirement gift in the future by depositing to your retirement accounts today. And also, this may be a gift for someone who may need it in the future, and you can create a legacy for your family. Trust me, your future self or future family will definitely appreciate it. So what do you think about this order of operations? Would you make any changes to the order? Has your company actually canceled their 401k match? If you still have a 401k match, are you actually taking advantage of it by maximizing on the minimum contribution you need in order to get the maximum match from your employer? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. I really appreciate you taking this time out of your day to watch this video. If you're not currently a member of the Mobile Money Nation, all you need to do is subscribe by hitting the subscribe button down below. Hit the like button because you really like this video, and also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video. Again, thanks for watching. Have a great day.